Now, from this PI System Explorer, you can choose to acknowledge the notifications. And there's actually two varieties of this. There's acknowledging the instance and acknowledging the subscription. And we'll talk more about that in just a few minutes. However, before we can use this in this particular example, we need a notification that we can acknowledge. Right now, if you recall, in my subscription, I did not require any acknowledgement. And that's why you're seeing all this instance acknowledged automatically. That's why you see that. So if I switch over to subscriptions, you can see the reason for that. Under my subscriptions options, there are no acknowledgements required. So let's do it this way. I'm going to require two acknowledgements. So that means bSmith, JHog, they're going to require, or both of those are going to require acknowledging for this to be an instance that is truly acknowledged. And that's really the difference between this over here when you see acknowledge subscription and acknowledge instance. See, the subscription is something only you can do, you can acknowledge for you as a subscriber. So if I'm logged in as R. Wells, I can acknowledge my subscription. I can't acknowledge that one user from his normal user interfaces can't acknowledge for anything other than himself. Now, if you, running PI System Explorer, want to acknowledge the entire notification, you can do that. So that would essentially specify that you've taken some action to resolve the notification, and you simply want to dismiss it without going through the normal subscription acknowledgments. So let's actually see this once we configure this to require acknowledgement. And so now, if you look under here, we have two required acknowledgments. Let's go ahead and trigger another notification. I'll go ahead and do this, and we'll come back and take a look at the notification that's generated. And so what I'm doing now, I'm going to go ahead and use, that system management tool to throw a value greater than 300 into that tag that we're using in the element attribute. And let me go back now, and in my history here, I'm going to choose to look at the active notifications. And there we go. We see that there is a notification that's triggered. And you notice there are no acknowledgments at this point. The reason there are no acknowledgments automatic is because, as I said, we're requiring acknowledgments this time. It's not automatic. Well, that means that if I take a look at the history, you should see that we now have the option to acknowledge this. Now, I can acknowledge the instance, in which case, it's basically saying, we're done. It doesn't matter if both people haven't acknowledged yet. We're just done at this point. Now, if I were logged in as these individual users, JHog, bSmith, and R. Wells, then I could acknowledge the subscription. I'm not logged in as any one of those, so I can't. Well, actually, I can't log in as one of those users. The virtual machine I'm using won't allow me to do that. But this would be normally where, you know, if you're logged in as a Windows user, as that Active Directory user, then we do take advantage of Windows Integrated Security, and then that would be an option available to me. So would that acknowledge the entire notification? Well, no. If I just acknowledged as one of these users, it won't because it requires two acknowledgments. So in order for this to work, I'd have to, you know, I'd have to go ahead and log in as two different users, or, you know, acknowledge them from within the email. Either one, that's the only thing that's going to clear this. But as I said, from here, I, as a user of the PI System Explorer, I can acknowledge the entire instance. Yeah, that's going to go ahead and basically retire this notification. I can optionally put in a comment. There we go. And so that should no longer be sending out any escalations at this point. We're not going to be resending those because it's been acknowledged. As you can see, it's been acknowledged, and it's acknowledged by the administrator. Now, in addition, one of the things we can do is we can make comments on these notifications. So, for example, I can go back to recent notifications or the current notification, the current active ones. Any of these would do. I can just choose right mouse click and choose add comment, and then we'll go ahead and add comment to this notification. And if you recall, we store the comments, so that is something you're going to be able to take a look at later on. Now let me go ahead and refresh this screen. There we go. Now the last thing I'd like to go over is this option here called Show Contact Events. The Show Contact Events is what allows you to either, you know, drill down through the individual events or just show the raw notifications. Okay. And then finally, we have this View Notifications Rule Summary. You know, sometimes from within here, you can't really remember what the rule is. And instead of going out to this trigger, you can just do this Notification Rule Summary, and that shows you what the notification rule is.